It's always exciting in the Southland. This past Saturday, a Kevin Hardy slam in the final seconds helped McNeese defeat Houston Baptist 70-68. Last Thursday, a last-second layup by Sam McBeat got Nicholls the last-second win over HBU. What will happen tonight? Nicholls and McNeese State are next. We're at the Lake Charles Civic Center, the McNeese State Cowboys, home away from home. The students are back in session today, and they're ready for some college basketball. Welcoming in the visitors from Thibodeau, the Nicholls Colonels, Southland Conference Basketball on CSN. Hello, everyone. Welcome inside. I'm Brett Dolan. Great to have you with us. Should be an exciting matchup tonight, and you're in for a treat sitting in our analyst chair this evening. A two-time college All-American, number one draft pick in the NBA by the Houston Rockets, part of a 14-year career, and then on to coach in the NBA for three different teams, most recently the Cleveland Cavaliers, and it's the one and only Houston basketball legend, John Lucas. Coach, good to have you with us tonight.
Good to be here, Brett. I am so excited about the Southland Conference and these two teams. They're very evenly matched.
Boy, they certainly are. They're travel partners, so they've knocked off the same four teams. They've lost to the same two teams.
Yes, they have, and it's going to be an interesting matchup for both teams. They're very high in the standings.
You see the standings, a familiar name up on top, Stephen F. Austin. Then you get down to Nicholls and, of course, McNeese State, both 4-2. It's such a busy conference, you have to flip the standings. You see Northwestern State, Central Arkansas, Houston Baptist, and then Lamar round out the entire conference. Now back to tonight's action for the Nicholls Colonels. It's a team that will employ four guards in their starting lineup.
They're going to really spread the floor, a lot of dribble drive and three-point shots. I love the way they attack the ball.
Dentrell Thomas is 26 points away from 1,000 in his career. It's also his birthday tonight. And Jeremy Smith, he's gone from walk-on to team captain.
What a great story Jeremy Smith is. Really done a great job, really does a great job moving the ball. And he's the heart and soul of that team.
As far as the Cowboys are concerned, they have one of the better players in the conference, a stat stuffer. He will do a little bit of everything, and that's Kevin Hardy.
Yes, Kevin does a lot of things and moves well without the ball. You saw the dunk in the opening highlight. He is really, really a great player to watch.
And Nicholls has never met a shot he hasn't liked.
Just like his dad who played in the NBA.
He will look to shoot from long range, and so will the Cowboys. Southland Conference basketball from Lake Charles. Tonight's winner will be 5-2 in conference play. The Colonels and the Cowboys, our starting lineup and tip, are next on CSN. Back at the Lake Charles Civic Center, the McNeese State Cowboys are evicted from their home arena due to the rodeo for three games each year. So here at the Civic Center tonight, a pair of 4-2 teams in league play, and time to take a look at our starting lineups. First, for the visitors from Nicholls. Again, a four-guard lineup. We featured Dantrell Thomas and Jeremy Smith in the open, but also TJ Carpenter, a man who will give them some points.
Carpenter is really a scorer, can really do a lot if you'll watch them. A lot of back pick, a lot of movement, spreading the floor.
Nicholls is coached by J.P. Piper in his 10th year, a Louisiana native. He has been around for quite some time and feels like he's got a pretty good team.
Really, you know, he also started as an assistant coach there.
So J.P. Piper, the head coach for the Colonels, in the starting lineup then for the McNeese State Cowboys. Talked about Kevin Hardy. and Ledric Eccles, Adrian Fields, Craig McFerrin, and Deshara Guidry. Maybe the most athletic player on the court.
They are. Guidry will really be their inside presence. Hardy will give them the outside, and Eccles the shoot. They're more built like a pro team, very similar to the Utah Jazz.
Little bigger team, certainly run more of a pro set, and their head coach is Dave Simmons in his eighth year. He played at Louisiana Tech. He will never be the most famous basketball alumni from that school.
No, we told him that today. But Carl Malone, but he's been the coach of the year twice in the Southland Conference. That's a very good job also.
He had a great season a couple of years ago. Last year, his team went 14-17, hoping that his team can win some games here at home because they had a stretch earlier this year where they had nine straight road games. And then, John, they finished the year in conference play, seven of their last nine games away from home, magnifying the importance to win these contests.
Yeah, this game is critical for the home team. When they play each other at home, especially being 4-2, this is a must-win for McNeese. I think McNeese will be the favorite. And if they get inside and attack with Guidry, they'll get a chance to get to the foul.
Coach Simmons told us today it doesn't matter where these two teams are in the conference race or in the standings. They always seem to play close games. In fact, last year they had three games decided by a total of 7 points.
Very similar. Great Southland Conference basketball. Every, you know, Sam Houston is the class of the division, but the rest of these teams are evenly matched. As you can look at their outer schedule early at the year, those teams that look like losing records play tougher opponents that have them up in the Southland Conference.
We're going to touch on that a little bit later on. Look at the schedules for both of these teams, including McNeese. Going back to last year, though, Nicholls won here in Lake Charles. And the McNeese went down to Thibodeau. They won in double overtime. They played 2 days later in the conference tournament, and McNeese won again.
But this is based on this year and watching these two teams. This is a home and home deal. McNeese must win this game to stay up ahead of Nicholls. If not, Nicholls has the advantage that they can come steal tonight. But got to be very careful. That's why it's important that McNeese starts inside with Guidry before those 3 points from Skip Gould so they can get to the foul line. And then Nicholls, they don't want to go to the foul line. They want to shoot threes, but no foul shooting.
Yeah, Nicholls shooting 59% from the free throw line. About a week ago, they were 345th in the nation in that category. The bad news is there's only 345 teams.
Brad, there's only one guy I know could have shot worse free throws, and he's sitting to my left. All right, don't take it personal.
Hey, I got my 300 shots in today waiting for these teams to get their shoot around. Of course, this facility was used not that long ago for some monster trucks, so there was some dust they had to clean up. They had to work around that in the shoot-around to get ready for two games today with a women's contest before this one.
I know, and they really did a good job getting it ready. It's really good.
You've been involved in these rivalry games. What is the extra motivation or significance when you're playing a team that you desperately want to beat?
Well, you know, both teams really know each other. So they know it. Now, you know, Nicholls will run a lot of Auburn shuffle, a lot of cuts, back cuts, spread the floor, dribble drop. And you can see they got guards who can handle the ball. McNeese is going to run a lot of pick and screens and try to start inside out and shoot the three. They're either in or out of in. But they've got to figure out a way to take advantage of these guards in the middle.
We're ready for basketball tonight. McNeese leads the all-time series 46-32, and it's the Cowboys will have the basketball first in our first look at Kevin Hardy. Nicholls really feels like they can take the Cowboys out of what they want to do, but J.P. Piper said that concerns me because McNeese pretty good at improvising when they have to.
Well, you know, McNeese right now is trying to go inside the Guidry to get the ball in. There's our first three by Nicholls. Look like the efforts.
McBeat the rebound.
Watch the movement and the ball movement and the dribble drive. That's a tough call, but see, I got to the rim and attacked it right away. Floor spread for them to be able to attack the basket all the time.
Some quickness from Jeremy Smith, but also whistled for the traveling violation. You saw our officials, and now the second possession of the night for the Cowboys.
Really, McNeese right now, Brett, is really trying to go high-low, get the ball inside, move it. And they're not being overplayed. Nicholls is just making a perimeter defense, not pressuring any other ball to pass.
you're the Nicholls defense, do you allow them to take some threes early, or do you try and push them as far away from the basket as possible?
Try to have them take threes. This is the second three.
Kevin Hardy for three.
Kevin Hardy knocks in the triple, a man averaging nearly 12 a game. Colonels would prefer this game be in the 60s. They average 67 a contest. There's Thomas for the easy lay-in and a foul.
And see, Brett, there's the movement, the picks, side to side, cut to the basket. That's a high-presented shot inside. It's going to be
Dandrell Thomas.
There's a good look, Coach. You see the defender, which was Gidry.
A great entry pass into the post. Very good seal, very good cut.
Thomas adds the free throw. They'll take that. Maybe a good omen for a team shooting less than 60% from the stripe this season, but improving.
This is McNeese's box set. Their first two possessions have been threes. Another three.
What a tough shot there from Adrian Fields. Jeremy Smith was double-teamed. There's McBeath, one of the many Australians on this Colonels team, and Smith was fouled near the baskets.
They really did a great job of spreading the floor, Brett. You see where they push it up, spread the floor, try to go strong side to weak side, and the middle's open. A little bit like a European offense where there's no post. So that's what the reason for the four guards, meaning that they're going to be looking to get to the post. And Smith is kind of like a post player. He wants to get inside and shoot his shots. In the paint.
So spacing of the floor is so very important.
Critical for them. And their fives are really ones who can shoot threes, and the little guys can really post. Smith does a good job getting into that lane.
Coach Piper wants everybody to be able to shoot. Now you see one of two free throws from Smith from the stripe, and the Colonels lead by a point. Kevin Hardy had the game-winning dunk the other day.
Yeah, really good off the dribble, but they need something in that paint. And here it is in the Gidry.
Deshara Gidry with the lead-in using the basket.
That's where they have an advantage right there. The first three of the four shots have been 3 points. Then they went inside and got it easy.
Quality look from Gidry. Your average is just under 11 a game. Dantrell Thomas got open. His shot was blocked from behind by McFerrin.
Dantrell Thomas.
Three of their shots, foul, and two in the paint. 6 points in, three of the four. So the ball move right now, Nicholls is trying to force themselves into the paint, all up in the spot. And there again, they're back inside the game.
A miss from point blank range, and you see the hand clap from Gidry. Let's go back to that previous play from Thomas, who had a shot blocked, but able to pick it up and then score again.
It's the Gidry inside. I think that is strong inside again. And again, now they're back inside again. That's where they got their change. Brett, that's their advantage. And limit the threes out of movement. Don't come down and shoot early threes, but move the ball.
Easy look for McFerrin.
Now you see, so now McNeese has gone to a zone because now they have been able to stop them getting in the paint. So this is a real adjustment for Coach Simmons to try to change up what the look is.
See how the Colonels shoot from the perimeter.
Because of the zone. They didn't get inside that time. Very good. Very good adjustment.
Cowboys trying to push the tempo, and the shot would not drop from Eccles. Shane Rillier. Young man from New Orleans.
Their zone offense is an overload to one side, to the middle, swing to the weak side, looking for a three. Haven't gotten it yet, but they're still trying to get to that point. Another paint shot by Smith. And so it looks like they're spraying the floor, and you think, I got to guard the perimeter. But what they're really doing is dribble driving them to get to the basket.
Evenly matched two teams playing an evenly matched contest here tonight. It's the Cowboys by a point.
Good.
Absolutely.
Yeah, well, good. I saw him go to the zone. You know, he told us earlier that he would, and then he scored.
You think they'll leave him in that zone for a while?
Yeah, they can't guard him.
Yeah.
Can't guard him. And the other point, Brett, you should make is that neither team has a shot blocker.
Right.
So
right.
Help. So now what they're doing really works for them, but they've got to stay inside. Like the shot echoes too quick. That three's too quick when they just scored three times in the post.
Right.
I didn't want to kill it.
It's worth bringing up, though.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? And then the first three shots, the threes. Mm-hmm. One bad one, two bad ones.
Yep.
One
good.
And their first three were in the paint.
That's right. Right.
Now, the key for Nicholls is that they can make free throws.
Exactly.
Fans, baseball and softball season will soon be here. Season tickets are now on sale. You can reserve your season tickets by visiting McNeeseSports.com. You call the ticket office.
He got the first one.
In Nashville.
I like it. 10 seconds back.
Diamond dinner. It'll be going on.
Cowboys leading by a point early.
You know, Brett, this is their fourth and fifth free throw already in the first and three team fouls. So this is working for them if they can make their free throws, but it doesn't do any good. It is kind of like a kiss of death to get there and then not make the free throws.
Coach Piper said, in my 37 years as a player or a coach, I have never gone through this. He says, we recruit shooters. We expect them to be able to shoot. Their frustrations at the free throw line have been difficult this year, and that's one of two from Smith. And now a turnover by the Colonels. Numbers are there. Easy laying for Jeremy Smith.
Jeremy Smith's points come in the paint. They have yet to shoot for one outside shot. And if they get steals, they turn that transition. Quickly, they get to the other end.
Be one of the few times that the Colonels try and push the tempo.
Yep. Looks like they're going to run off misses and really run their stuff off mates.
Adrian Fields from the baseline. Rillier had it in his hands, but he was popped from behind out of bounds. It'll be Colonels ball.
Right. Too many threes too quick on the shot clock when they've scored inside consistently. They've got to be patient, especially out of their box set, and get the ball back inside. That shot was taken with 24 seconds on the shot. You got to be making those shots, but then they have to defend.
And the three will drop from T.J. Carpenter. So Carpenter, one of the big three scorers for the Colonels, gets his first basket, and you see Nicholls up by five.
That was Carpenter's first shot, too.
Boy, just to force it, it dropped from Nicholls.
That's unbelievable. That's a good shot. That's one of his dad's shots. I remember his dad as a great scorer in the league, and he did with the Washington Bullets.
That is Liddell.
Now, you notice, when they score, they go back to his own. So that's to slow the ball down. But now we're already at 15 seconds on the shot clock, and the ball is going to both sides before three times. So you've had to move side to side, strong side, weak side, back to strong. Really good ball, but Coach Piper is doing a great job of moving the ball.
T.J. Carpenter, who made the three from the baseline, pops up from the wing and knocks down another triple. So McNeese led by a point early, but Nicholls has been able to hit here in the second segment. And a rebound to Jeremy Smith. Neither one of these two teams very good rebounders, with not a lot of height and a lot of long-range shots. Smith, another one. The triples are falling for the Colonels, and that's seven quick points for Jeremy Smith, and Coach Simmons wants a timeout.
Well, Brett, explain to me, like I'm a four-year-old, how they can hit all these threes and struggle at the free throw line.
Did you ever find out, though, as a coach, and this is what Coach Piper is going through right now, the more you emphasize something, the more it becomes a mindset, maybe a negative aspect. He has said, we try and come up with ways to put pressure on kids in practices without them realizing we're testing them.
You know, I had a guy play for me, Dennis Rodman, one of the worst free throws user in the league. And we never talked about it. It always made me shoot. But look at the ball movement and it's Smith's form and technique. He's really feeling good about himself right there as he comes back.
All right, so Coach Simmons went with the man-to-man early. It led to some easy shots in the paint. He's going to the zone, and Nicholls has made the three. So what does he do defensively?
Well, he's got to mix his game. But the problem right now is on offense. Not as much defense. They got to score some buckets. And then here's their box again, and they're now back inside. And that's where they have to be.
Trying to get that easy basket out of the timeout. Could not convert, but he'll have free throw.
Here again, they slow the game down and get to the foul line. And they're inside. Their advantage, if you got loose and you got bigs, it would make sense to go to the bigs inside. You can't keep shooting threes if you got the bigs. And it's very good here. You come up out the box. That's a great entry into the post. A nice up and under. Leaves him a left hand, though.
Would have helped with the finish.
Yeah, would have helped with the finish.
McFerrin of Baton Rouge, Louisiana native. A lot of Louisiana natives, of course, for both teams. And McFerrin gets one of the two free throws.
I like this. They've gone to a press trying to find out what can slow Nicholls down. And there's the first steal.
Guidry with the turnover. Keelan Garrett up and under it in. There's a Lake Charles native coming off the bench to provide a boost.
Yes, and now they're in a zone. 2-2-1 full-court zone press after they scored. And it's mixing them up. Coach Simmons is doing a good job trying to find out what he can do to slow down the ball movement.
Trying a little bit of everything here in our first 8 minutes from Lake Charles. The entry pass for Cade Towers was knocked away, but a foul was committed.
A lot of movement. I love the offense concept of what they're doing. They're going strong to the weak side, moving the ball, and they went inside. They weren't looking to score on the post feet. They were looking for help for a three because Carpenter's just made two.
And for the Colonels, a 6-3.
You see the 3-point shots. Neither team is able to make a successful living from long range, but tonight the Colonels, 3 out of 4.
The right threes.
McFerrin took a seat after getting the foul. Austin Lewis, a Houston kid, checks in. And TJ Carpenter almost got his third three. He was hoping for the roll. Kevin Hardy locates Garrett left alone. He was lost on the baseline. He buries the three.
Now that three guard, it was a good three. It was quick out of transition, and they had rebounding position. That's a different three. Now they're back to man-to-man. I love the defensive changes. It's kind of like a pitcher. He's changing his calls every possession.
He's changing speeds, mixing in the breaking pitches, everything.
Well-disciplined team, Nicholls. They take their time. They're late in the shot clock now, and another paint drive.
Shane Rillier
with the hoop. Meanwhile, McNeese on the other end. Almost a quick basket in transition.
The foul is called the Colonels. Jeremy,
well, the 3-point shot has been a big part of our game. We expected that. We've seen it tonight from the Colonels. Shooting from long range, and of course, it was Garrett answering for the Cowboys.
Okay.
J.P. Piper's Colonels off to a good start, and John, they've done so, knocking down some three-point shots.
Well, yes, they have, and you know, Carpenter's taken all four, and all of his shots have been three. He's 2-for-4 from the three-point, and they're not known for their three-point shooting. Smith has made one, and so it's Carpenter made the other for the 3 out of 5 shots. It gives them 9 points. Been very good.
See Jeremy Smith there at the paint. He scored 7 to lead the way. Keelan Garrett to the free throw line. He had a quick 5 off the bench for the Cowboys, but missed the first of 2 from the stripe.
He's come in, and his speed has made a little bit of a difference for them because they went smaller also. McNeese went a little smaller, and they matched their speed of the 4 guards. So if you look out on the court, Nicholls is really like a 3 for McNeese now. So he's moved from the 2 to the 3 to match up with the small guards that Nicholls has on the court.
It's like T.J. Carpenter has to have something taped up, maybe a little blood, before we can resume play here from the Lake Charles Civic Center.
He needs to put his gloves on, doesn't he? Wait. He's got to put his arm down.
Into the game now for the Colonels, a 6'5 freshman from Oviedo, Florida.
He's going to have to check out.
Number 33, Luke Doyle.
Luke Doyle, Florida native, checks in.
One of the few players that's not from Louisiana that's on the both rosters.
Or Australia. Keelan Garrett already with a season average here in about 4 minutes of play.
And Garrett has had an impact on the game because of speed as they're moving. Now they're back to the press.
Chuck away from the ball. This one looks like it's going against Cade Towers. An offensive chip there from one of the big men from the Colonels.
The third Colonels team foul. Dantrell Thomas and Sam McBeat return for the Colonels.
Dantrell Thomas checks right back in after being attended to during that last dead ball.
Well, you know, McNeese, Brett needs to go inside, try to get that 15 foul and get in the penalty because that's an advantage for them. And they do it again out the box set in the get you. It's very good patience.
Garrett has had the hot hand. Not that time. And the floor rebound to Thomas. Thomas looks to push. He'll keep. He'll use the finger roll. So the two men we featured in the open, Jeremy Smith, Dantrell Thomas, they've each scored 7 points.
Yes.
I love it when a plan comes together.
Yes.
Cowboys still trying to find that rhythm and trying to get that man, Deshari Guidry, involved. You see the double team. He'll lean in, go high off the glass, and the Colonels collect.
That's a great play by Eccles.
How about that play? Ledrick Eccles. Able to get the takeaway and the basket and a chance for a three-point play after the Thomas foul.
We always tell players, never throw the ball back in underneath your basket. That's the steal that they got. They threw the ball back in, and Eccles was there for it right there on the back. Three-point play. This guy scores in multiple ways. Threes, off-balance shots, contact, can really finish on contact as he just did. Uh-oh.
Little draft in this building, apparently. I mean, they've been having these large garage door open up all afternoon with the wind blowing in.
Somebody left the door open up.
You're talking about a man who went 14 of 14 from the free throw line in one game earlier this year, and he throws up an air ball. Then again, this is the first time the Cowboys have played in this facility this year. There really is no home court advantage.
Not for them, especially with the rodeo advantage. Good steal, though.
Eccles with another steal. And how about him getting that shot up against Doyle as he was being tackled to the floor?
Well, you know, as this game pans out, Brett, the more athletic team is McNeese. The more disciplined team on running their stuff right now happens to be Nicholls. So on the double teams into the post and get you, they've got to be patient to still give him a second look once the ball comes out of there. And not be so quick to shoot the first. Eccles is normally a pretty good free throw shooter. Just shot an air ball and missed one. Let's see what he needs to be doing to get himself back on track.
82% from the line in nearly 100 free throws, so it's a pretty big sample size. You even see him shake his head right there as he goes and shoots and converts. So more backcourt pressure employed by McNeese State. All along, Dantrell Thomas for the flush.
Thomas and Carpenter really been a factor.
Nicholls with the three try, and Austin Lewis gets whistled for the foul, jumping up to try and grab that rebound.
Cowboys Austin Lewis, his first personal foul, their 15th foul.
Lewis, a 6'8 sophomore from Westfield High School in the Houston area.
Yes, saw him play a lot, and that's why I'm from Houston, saw him play a lot out there by the airport, in and out, intercontinental. Did a very good job for us. And back to the zone. We've got to guard the middle. And they did the same identical thing. Flashed the young man in the middle, and then they didn't seal down the lane. Thomas starts in the middle, and then just dives right down the middle from the ball moving the weak side. Watch, he'll go middle. Ball here, now watch him dive. Right there, open lane.
Is that his quickness that's allowing him to get to the rim, or is that not good defense?
That's not good defense. That's the swing of the ball. The weak side guy has to stay in front of Thomas until they can help. But then they can flip the ball to the other side, then he has him pinned down low. So they need to make an adjustment in what zone they're in. This is a very good event. Coach Piper and Coach Simmons are really playing a chess match so early and a high scoring game.
I like the way you set that up, the athletic team against the disciplined team, and you coaches love those chess matches.
Yeah.
You also like guys who can come off the bench and provide nine quick points like Keelan Garrett.
He's been real good.
His career high is 14. He has nine in fewer minutes. But the Cowboys have not hit an answer for Dantrell Thomas. He just lost the basketball there, and Garrett comes up with the steal, and we had a foul. It was Thomas trying to get that ball back, commits the personal on Keelan Garrett.
Thomas called on Dantrell Thomas, his second personal foul. It is the
Thomas trying to get that back. One of the things I always tell players, you make a mistake, don't multiply it by getting another mistake. And that's what he did. And now he gets himself out the game for the rest because he multiplied that mistake.
You know, that makes perfect sense. I know it's something that you tell kids at any level. Once you get to the NBA, do they start to learn that? Does that soak in more, that lesson, or is that something where frustrations always seem to win out?
It gets worse in the fall. Because you don't have as much control. They make too much money.
Kevin Hardy's just trying to get a goal, and that really wasn't a very good look. And the rebound to Torres. Nicholls has committed seven turnovers, make it eight, to just one for McNeese. And, Coach, if it weren't for the TOs, Nicholls might have really have a larger lead than just 4 points.
You're right. If it wasn't for the turnovers in the way. But right now he had the wrong guy. Coach Piper, I know that look.
Yeah.
I know that look. And, you know, the young man who made the mistake just then just took him out the game. He wasn't supposed to be held in the ball. And that ball should be with Smith.
Leads to another turnover. See if the Cowboys
That's
can
a great,
convert.
Great entry pass.
And McFerrin able to get the foul on McBeath.
Eccles made a great delivery into the post. They've got to keep that game inside.
Nicholls State team foul. Two shots for Craig McFerrin.
Let's look at McBeath, the young man from Sydney, Australia, a 23-year-old sophomore.
Looking at that. Look, that's nice. Thrilling up in the left hand. It would do him better if he got on the other side so he could use his right hand back to the baseline.
Either that or he's going to have to come to a few of your camps and have you work with him on that left hand.
Well, he can use my left hand. I would love his right hand.
Another player who splits a pair from the stripe. 4 points for McFerrin. Another close game as we anticipated. Colonels with the lead in the basketball here tonight from Lake Charles. Another turnover. Eccles has been in the middle of things. To the rim. Eccles can't finish. He'll go back to the stripe. And Ledrick Eccles, we talked about his three-point shooting. It has been his defense and his steals tonight that have given the Cowboys a boost. Big game, though, from Dantrell Thomas.
He catches him in that zone press, and he comes right down the lane and sees him really good.
Hey!
Southland Conference basketball tonight from Lake Charles. The Colonels from Nicholls leading 26-23. And let's take a look at our mid-major top 10 around college basketball. Wichita State, they're one of three unbeatens remaining in college hoops. You see some familiar names. Harvard, a tournament team last year, in Gonzaga. And there's Stephen F. Austin from the Southland, number 7.
Brett, those are really good teams in there. Stephen F. Austin's in there. And a lot of those mid-majors are beating up on what they consider the powers.
Stephen F. Austin, they lost Danny Casper, their coach, to Texas State. The winning has continued with a good foundation to that program. Meanwhile, more woes from the free throw line for Ledrick Eccles. He now has 6 points. But, John, you were looking at the stats for the Colonels. 9 of 12 from the field to this point.
It's shooting 75% because it's all layups and three wide open threes. And then the other thing is, when you're making shooting 75%, McNeese has 4 rebounds. 4 rebounds to 10. So they've got to adjust that on what they're doing.
McBee with the triple again, John, a 23-year-old sophomore, a man who came from Australia. He had 18 months to decide whether or not he was going to play college basketball, used that waiver, able to play now, and he is what Coach Piper said, the toughest kid I've ever coached.
Yes. Look at him guard there.
Really loves the way he pushes his teammates, and you always need somebody like that to kind of control the team on the floor.
What I like about him is he's talking on defense, calling screens, picking. Look how he's moving his feet there as he guards.
Shot clock at 3. Eccles has to push. He got the friendly shooter's roll. 8 points for Eccles.
Eccles is a scoring machine. You know, if he had his free throws, it hurt him some, but he's really scored a lot of points, all in the paint on tough shots.
Like what Coach Simmons told us today, he's a volume guy. That means he likes to shoot a lot.
Yeah, high volume.
Right. You'll get your points if you shoot enough, right? Tough move on the low blocks from Jeremy Smith.
Nicholls strong the weak side cuts. Weak side with strong cuts off picks. Having their big set picks. Moving my flashes right there off a cut.
Great pump fake to get Eccles in the air. Smith, the New Orleans native, will get the friendly roll. His free throw shooting percentage almost identical to the team, 59.6.
And so far they're 6 for 8 on the free throw line tonight.
Don't you think they're just too good of a shooting team to have that free throw percentage for that long?
They should. You know, probably shouldn't address the comment or even comment about it, because all it does is bring more attention to it and gives you more unwanted pressure.
Jeremy Smith with 9 points. The Colonels build that lead back to 5. McNeese State has just not found that rhythm yet offensively. That was a tough pass to McFerrin.
From the middle, can't make that pass from the middle of the floor. Here they go into their cuts. One pick, shuffled into the weak side.
Doyle was open, they didn't hit it. So the Colonels aren't afraid to use some of the shot clock, especially when they're leading. They'll get an open look, and that's Jeremy Smith again. So both Thomas and Smith with 11 points.
They've got to decide how they're going to defend. The zone has been the best for them and the pressure, but the problem is they can't score enough right now to set their defense.
Good look from Guidry to McFerrin. He could not drop it in. Villiers will push, and the teardrop wouldn't drop. Kevin Hardy the rebound. Ahead to Garrett. Keelan Garrett's keeping the Cowboys in this game.
That's what you call a real six man. He's really, this one is 11 points already for him before the half.
Basket is good for Keelan.
And he scored in multiple ways. That is a nice finish. You know, the Southland Conference, they don't have really big beaks, but they have some very good guards who can beat you off the dribble in the whole conference. So this is a guard on a beat. And if you do get a big, you don't have a lot of depth with your bigs. So everybody's playing one position out of position. So your four is really a 5, and your 3 is really a 4. And so that's why your guards is primarily a guard league and not a lot. A lot of shot blocking, so you can attack the rim.
Gotta believe you also have some players with some chips on their shoulders in
this
league.
Yes.
Jeremy Smith controls. He's been one of the hot hands tonight for the Colonels. Going against Kevin Hardy, a talented defensive player, but the look to Rillier, another backdoor layup.
Which means no rebounds. They're always taking it out.
You and I might be the second leading rebounder for McNeese at the half. There's a tough shot in traffic by McFerrin.
McFerrin, you see they put him on the other side to
That's
his right hand versus
They're
his
They're listening
left
to
hand.
You.
You know, brother,
play to your strengths, right?
Yes.
75% from the field for the Colonels, 12 of 16. Their only problem has been turnovers. There was a near TO, and Hardy couldn't save it.
That strong, the weak side cut. The ball is on the strong side, and they setting picks on the weak, cutting them to the post. They can post any of the four guards, and normally it's Smith. And then Carpenter is a picker and a rim runner, especially as a result. That's how he gets his, and he's a three-point shooter. They're kind of a unique team, kind of hard to guard. They're very good at getting to the foul line, and therefore no rebounding, not a lot of runouts for McNeese yet. And in order for McNeese to play the way they want to play, they've got to get rebounds and run.
Rillier with the front end miss on the one on the bonus. So the Cowboys back with the basketball. So Kevin Hardy has been quiet, 1 3-point basket in the game. Meanwhile, Desharet Guidry has just one field goal. Hardy was open, didn't get the pass from Guidry. The Cowboys need to shoot. Sean Johnson will jack one up, and he'll bang one in from the wing.
He's got to call that one now. He's got to call that day.
All right, Coach, back to this defense. I may have to wait for a second as Smith controls. Smith into the paint. Did he walk with it? Yes, he did. As far as McNeese State is concerned, they probably just haven't seen many teams like this. And we'll come back. I want to get your thought when we come back. Meanwhile, it's been a lot of these easy layups for the Colonels. That's my. I wanted to get your thought on the difficulties for McNeese playing defense because they don't see it very often. And I'll get to that if I can ever.
At a basketball game?
You know, what it really is, it's an Australian, a European offense where the ball is moving. It's a version of how you would play if you're not athletic.
Yeah.
So what you're doing is getting your pure ball player versus the athleticism.
I see.
It's what we talked about at the top of the show.
Yeah.
Well, it's a good thing this isn't time, isn't it?
6 rebounds. And still shooting 75%.
That's amazing. Cowboys have to be thrilled to only be down one considering the way Nicholls has shot the basketball.
Nicholls has shot the ball great. They should be up double digits, but the problem is turnovers. They've got 10 turnovers. They're shooting 75% from the field, 66% from the three, and 70% from the free throw line. Now, McNeese's problem is the free throw line. They're 6 for 12. But inside basket, they've got to continue to do that and eliminate the double team of Gidry from the recap. I love what Coach Williams did coming out of the timeout. He overloaded and took away the double team.
And Gidry's basket puts McNeese State up a point. We've been talking about the difficulties, though, for the Cowboys defending this Colonels offense. And John, they just don't see this much in college basketball.
You know, it's very much like a European offense with the ball moving side to side. Now, they've been guarding for 30 seconds before that three went up. You got to guard that every time. It's discipline on the defensive end of knowing what you want to do. Very good shape.
Nicholls State back up by a pair. We expected an evenly matched game. We've had that here tonight. Two old rivals. And Jemiah Bird off the bench for a field goal.
That bench has really come in and got about 15 points for McNeese. It's really kept them in the game. Really made a big difference for them. And they went smaller to match up with Nicholls.
In fact, now it's 17-0 bench points in favor of the Cowboys. That's where the boost has come. And there was a foul from behind before that ball went sailing out of bounds. Charge to Keelan Garrett.
His first personal foul, 19 foul.
Each team with 9 team fouls. And it didn't feel like we had a lot of personals in the first 5 or 6 minutes, but they picked up since.
It's picked up. Both teams have 9. And one of the reasons is that McNeese started going inside, stopped shooting as many threes. And Nicholls has always been inside with cuts by goals from what they've done. The problem that lies right now is that free throw shooting for Nicholls will have to hold up in the second half.
T.J. Carpenter, in and out, no good again. So the Cowboys on the push. Keelan Garrett, not that time, and the rebound out to Relia.
Too quick of a three.
Not in rhythm.
Not in rhythm. And then they get up another basket because their advantage is inside. And Nicholls' advantage is moving the ball, making them guard and defend, hoping that they'll break down their discipline defensively.
Jeremy Smith, another easy basket. Colonels back up by 2. Eccles will launch for a 3. And Manu shoots nearly 7 of those a game.
He could get the ball back inside to Gidry off of an overload. Good drive. Yeah, great finish.
Rashawn Johnson got the block against McBeath.
You know, you made a great point earlier, but it's 19 points off the bench for McBeath.
His second personal foul, 10th team foul. Basket is good for Sean Johnson.
Here's Johnson, one of those coming off the bench, and it looked like McBeath may be moving a bit.
A year ago, that's a charge that he was already in his upward motion. And that's one of the new rule changes in college this year, that once the offensive player starts his motion, no more charge.
Do you like that?
I love it, because the offense should have some of that. That's a nice 3-point.
And it certainly has led to more scoring up about 8% this year in college basketball. I know free throws are also up, but I think everybody wanted to see more points scored.
I think it's good for the game.
I think this is more points than we anticipated, though, John, in this first half between these two teams.
Yes.
Kate Towers got too far under. He walked another turnover on the Colonel.
That's not a bad play. Forcing to try to use their big, that they're the one big they have in the game. Inside. That's a good post feed off the cut. Should have gone right up and gathered. He hesitated and went.
Cowboys leading by a point. Bird thought about it, and then he returns the favor.
Now, they were in what you call their dribble drive set, where if you notice the guy where they were driving, there was no post behind him. The problem was, they didn't give it a chance to develop. It was one pass, drive, looking to score. Its ball's got to get moving first. That's the difference here offensively. When Nicholls rush the ball, let's count it's the second pass. Cut. It's your third pass. See, they're really moving the ball and another. See, you have to get the defense to move left.
The
right. That's
Sean
the advantage.
The
they're not. That's
foul,
the distance between guarding the Coach Piper's team and guarding the traditional team that Coach Simmons. They're going to play, and they want to get the tempo up. The problem is, if you get behind them with Nicholls, it's going. If they make the free throws, it's going to take you 3 minutes to make up 8 points. You can't just come and shoot the home run because you got to defend to cut the lead. Mm-hmm. Then if you get out of your rhythm, the the only way you beat them is you must be up on Nicholls to make them play fast.
Villiers makes one of two from the line. Ball game tied at 41. Eccles, not bashful. That's a three-pointer, and he's got 11.
He's going to have a chance to make some money because he can shoot the ball. He has the definite skill being able to shoot the ball. And although he's a volume shooter, you never know when he's going to get.
Right.
He reminds me a lot of my son. Streaky, very streaky. You know, get on the roll.
I agree, streaky, but consistent enough to make at least one three-pointer in the 11 straight games, so he'll always get you something. DJ Carpenter had the hot hand earlier. First half winding down. Eccles looking up at the clock, picked up the ball, forces up a three, and it would not drop. What a first half here from Lake Charles. It looked like Nicholls had everything going early, but it's Dave Simmons, Cowboys, leading by three at the break. Score at the half, 44-41. McNeese coming up next. We'll go to the Comcast Sportsnet studio where we'll join Corey Heppelin. Sorry, I didn't know I had that copy there. So I wasn't sure I was throwing to that right away or what.
They have proudly been sponsored by Billy Navarre Chevrolet Cadillac for 17 consecutive years. Please enjoy.
Well, you're off.
Hey,
you.
This is Bruce Hemphill, AD.
Hey,
Bruce.
Bruce Hemphill.
Nice to meet you.
Good to see you too. Sit down.
Good. We're gonna.
Hey, John. Bruce Hemphill. Hey, I'm gonna find my finest at LSU anyway.
Bruce, we probably have 3 or 4 minutes before they're going to put us on. And
you tell me what you want to talk about. Right?
Well, I'll probably start with football and just talk about what a great season it was. Big win early on the road and, you know, go to the playoffs. And then we'll segue back into basketball, if you'd like, from there. I might ask you about the conference, too, about the changes in the conference with all the additions and, you know, what that's meant, if it's meant anything, or just different teams coming in, obviously, to play. And maybe finish with the basketball team, too, playing a very difficult schedule, but now a chance to go 5-2 if they can win tonight in conference play. Yeah. Oh, okay. All right.
More.
No, I told him he probably had 5 or 6 minutes.
Here's Brett.
Brett, right? Yeah, two teams. Yep. First year on the job, is that right?
Oh, gosh, I'm a veteran of 6 months now, Brett.
Where'd you come from?
Bounced around the country, always making it look like I was leading the parade out of town versus the posse chasing me out of town.
Right.
That's how college athletics is, isn't it?
That's right. That's right.
We're ready for the very first installment of Go Make
LSU, played football there. Coached there for a while with Charles McClendon, Louisiana Tech, NC State. University of South Carolina, University of North Carolina. and then University of Wyoming.
What we're gonna do here,
you have been busy.
Yeah, we have. Gonna stay one step ahead.
That's true.
But I'm back home. This is my home. This is where
Lake
I'm
Charles
from.
Is home?
Sulphur, which is about 10 minutes
okay.
from here.
Okay.
So, Kyla, I have in this envelope some cash. It could be a dollar, it could be $10, it could be $50, it could be.
I was gonna go over to campus today. I've never been there. I was supposed to do your football game, I think your first home game, and I ended up getting a conflict and I had to trade.
And
I was gonna drive over there today, but I was here for about 3.5 hours for the shoot around, so I may swing over tomorrow and take a peek. And
initially, what's.
It's interesting, it's the university I grew up with. So I remember coming to games. Of course, it looks so much bigger then than it does now. But still, we've got a beautiful campus, beautiful stadium, too. The largest football stadium in the conference.
Is it really?
Yeah, 17-8. So it's
general admission is $90.
It's good, and winning helps.
Oh, boy.
Sure.
You know, too.
Now, who did you lose to in the playoffs?
First round, or actually, we got a bye in the first round. Yeah. Lost in the second round to Jacksonville State, who the following week went up to Eastern Washington.
Oh, yeah. Now, was that at home that you played them, or did you?
It was at home.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We
number
were
three.
A sixth seed.
She denied the catch.
So,
let's see
didn't play very well.
Yeah, I know, it's disappointing. I had one game at Sam earlier this year. And that's when they were really looking pretty good. That was early on before they kind of faltered a bit. And then I did a game at Lamar later on in the South.
Let's see, let's
but
see
I didn't get you guys.
Cash, Kyla would have won if she would have secured
the cash in the envelope.
She goes away with nothing. Let's see what. Well, that was the winning one, number two.
I think so. You?
So. Thanks for playing. Good job.
Yeah, yeah, it's right. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I did too. There's no doubt because a couple times I hate to go too long, and I know Polly and I have talked about this. You know, someone scores a basket, then with 20 seconds I can't
we'll
even really tag it or identify it. But yeah, I think we're all right. Right. I didn't know at halftime. I wasn't sure where I was going on that with that copy or not. If we were just going straight to break, so that's my bad. I should have got a thought from him right there while you told me to do that copy. Okay. But are you going to show you going to show the Nicholls highlights first and then okay. You're getting all this behind the scenes TV stuff.
See, I don't hear your conversation.
Oh, okay. Okay. That's probably just as well.
I can hear you, but I don't hear the other person. Where are you from, bro?
Okay, now we're back on Iowa native, Iowa grad. I've been in Houston 8 years.
What do you want to get to?
Well, I was with the Astros for 7, and then they went through an ownership and management change, and there wasn't an 8. So we're trying to figure things out. And I haven't figured it out yet.
Interesting enough, they were here today.
That's what I know. I heard they were here raising the flag, and I just missed them, too. So,
is that a good thing?
No. I mean, the people that came in and caused all the damage are no longer there. Amazingly enough. But,
and that's something that works out?
Come in, torch about 80% of the people, and then in turn get your opportunity to leave. Okay. Thank you. Good ball game in Lake Charles. The McNeese State Cowboys leading over Nicholls by 3 at the half. And welcome back inside. I'm Brett Dolan with the athletic director here at McNeese State, Bruce Hemphill. He's been on the job all of 6 months, but Bruce, I know you're happy to be home here in Lake Charles.
It's a great honor. It's a dream come true, Brett, not only to be home, but to be able to be a part of a university that I grew up with, even though I didn't attend here. I went to that purple and gold school down in Baton Rouge, but it's been great to be back home.
Let's talk about football. What a fantastic season. You had the huge non-conference win in the state of Florida to start the year, and then a 10-win campaign.
It worked out very, very well. Starting that season off down in South Florida, winning there, and then going on to win 10-3 and going to the second round of the playoffs. It was an exciting time, and I give all the credit to our football coach and his staff, too. And my job in the first couple months there was not screwing up.
Hey, when you're an athletic director and the football team wins 10 games and go to the postseason, you're in pretty good stead to begin with.
I tell you what, I like those odds, too.
Let's talk about the basketball program since it is basketball season. The women's team had a tough loss earlier tonight, but they've had a pretty good campaign.
We do. We've had good success in the past with both our men's and women's program, too. We're going to be very, very competitive. And obviously, our goal is to win conference championships, and we're going to get there.
Men's team had a difficult stretch earlier this year. They were on the road for 9 straight games. Things have settled down a bit, off to a good start in conference play. And if they can get a win tonight, they'd be 5-2 in league play.
And back in the fight for the championship, too, which we knew that first part of the season, getting through that was going to be very, very difficult. And I promised Coach Simmons we would not be doing that again.
All right, what's next for the athletic program? You always have to be building something or preparing for the future. So what's next for the Cowboys and their fan base?
Well, we've got some ideas up on the board, too. Going through still the planning process and thinking about a lot of different things that we can do. Obviously, revenue is very important at schools, especially our size. So looking for different revenue streams to be able to build our programs and make it more successful.
Bruce, it's our pleasure to be here tonight. We appreciate your hospitality, and we'll do it again soon.
Look forward to having you back, Brett, you and John both, and the rest of your crew.
That's Bruce Hemphill, the athletic director at McNeese State at the half. We'll come back and take a look at our halftime and stats and highlights right after this.
Is that it?
Brett, really enjoyed it. Very professional. Thank you very much.
What the first half stats?
Okay, start with Nicholls 3-point shooting. 44-41, the McNeese State Cowboys with the lead at the half. And what an entertaining first half it was here from Lake Charles. Again, I'm Brett Dolan with John Lucas. And, Coach, we expected an evenly matched game. We've had that today. But it was Nicholls State jumping out to the early lead, and they did so shooting the three-point ball.
Shooting the three-point ball, scoring in the paint. The one thing that really helped them was that they were able to shoot the three-point ball, but turnovers hurt them. Turnovers kept them in the game right away. But look at the way they moved the ball and the spacing from side to side. On the carpet, they had 3 of the 4 three-pointers that they had.
And then, of course, Jeremy Smith, another part of his 13 points and a lot of productive shots. And Elon McBeath stepping out and knocking a couple of three-pointers down for the Colonel.
You know, their spacing on the three-point shooting is really good.
Meanwhile, the bench scoring has been big for the Cowboys. How about Keelan Garrett popping in 12 points?
He had 12, and they had about 18 points, I think, off the bench as a whole. But Garrett was the fact that they really led them off the bench. And then Eccles scores in a variety of ways. He's had threes. He's missed a couple of free throws. But what a guy that can really shoot the ball. He has that. He's a volume shooter, but he can really score.
Yeah, some steals and some points contributing to a Cowboys three-point lead at the half. We'll be back and get the second half underway from Lake Charles right after this.
Thank you.
We're off now, though, aren't we? Okay. We're done. You got it. We're rolling now.
20 points off the bench. I said 18. That was close.
Yep. Six run in the half.
Yeah. What's that?
McNeese went on a 15-6 run to finish the half. We don't have any more breaks, right, Mike? We're just stats to play. You got it.
No. Bench points and turnovers.
Yeah. And I'll just let you tee it up and I'll let you explain. Plus, the Cowboys by three at the half. Can you see the stats? The Colonels shooting nearly 74%, but the three-pointers and bench points and, of course, turnovers, John. Such a big part of our first 20 minutes.
Well, the three-point shooting on both is pretty even. It's been pretty good. The bench points is a big factor. The bench points have had McNeese and the Achilles heel for Nicholls. The reason why they went on that 15-6 run at the end of the half was turnovers. They turned the ball over at the end and got McNeese out where Eccles could get his three-point shooting and rhythm threes.
So the Colonels led by as many as nine, the Cowboys by three as we start play here in the second 20 minutes from the Lake Charles Civic Center. Southwestern Louisiana Livestock Show and Rodeo forcing the Cowboys out of their on-campus home for the next three games. Leaning in, T.J. Carpenter with the first two.
Now, Nicholls are back inside, back in. They move Carpenter around. Three-point shooter, they put him on the post that time. I love the way some of the things that they're doing, just like I do with McNeese. McNeese is now trying to get inside. Both teams are trying to start out inside with the ball in the paint.
I want to see what Kevin Hardy can do in the second half after a quiet first 20 minutes. There's Guidry. You got it. Following his shot, he had his hands on him briefly, and it's out of bounds right to Rowdy, and it'll remain
now,
McNeese ball.
I'm amazed that McNeese is ahead with Hardy doing limited stuff. He's got to come on. They're going to win this game. He's got to be a factor on either end of the court right now. He's there, but he's not being a factor on either side.
And a whistle away from the basketball. Eccles hit the floor.
The foul is called the Colonels. T.J. Carpenter.
And T.J. Carpenter picked up the personal. I'm with you, Coach. There's Kevin Hardy, a guy averages a couple of steals a game. He gets his blocks, a man averaging nearly seven rebounds. And here you see some of the contact on the inbounds play. But Hardy does a little bit of everything, but tonight he's been relatively quiet.
Well, that was for him, but they played the play for him. Again, they're trying to get inside. He's got to look for his offense. He's really looking to run the team.
Been the night for Keelan Garrett. Not that time. The tip by Hardy wouldn't go, and then he got another hand on it, but it wouldn't drop. So he got some rebounds, but no baskets.
Very active and long. It's a long arm for a guy that size. really good rebounder. Nicholls now is moving the ball side to side, now back inside. Second basket inside. Same way it started at the beginning of the game. The first four baskets were inside. And McNeese's first shots were outside. Although those two tipped by Hardy were really inside too.
Well, McBeath was lost underneath. It's the Colonels back up a point. So McNeese trying to find an open look. There's Hardy, wide open. And strong to Rillier. Left hand off the glass, Jeremy Smith.
Jeremy Smith is a great story. He walked on to a scholarship to like the heart and soul of his Nicholls team.
Coach Piper affectionately said we tried to run him off for 2 years, and he just refused to quit. He called him a dirty work guy, but he said really it's what college basketball is all about. What a great story.
What a very good story for him, and hopefully he can continue to play because he really has some length and size to be able to play overseas or go somewhere and play. I love his competitiveness.
Meanwhile, McBeath, the young man from Australia, two times he's had foot surgeries. It's a wonder he's on the floor, and you could see him get all alone for that easy lay-in.
Yeah, backdoor cut from the weak side.
Deshaurik Guidry to the line.
Guidry's at the foul line. They have to overload and pull away the other big out because they're double-teaming Guidry when he gets the ball in the low post, which is really effectively making him move out. Now what they've got to do is find a way to get the ball and give him a second look. But what's going on with him is that they now have slowed the rhythm of their game down and the pace is quicker from Nicholls.
Guidry picked up the foul on Thomas. That is the first here in the second half for the Cowboys.
This is a different game. A lot of ebb and flows to it. Tonight, you know, it's really what we thought it would be, and both teams are playing to their strength. Turnovers have really hurt Nicholls, but again, there's a zone out of the out of bounds this time. This game has followed the same path that it did at the beginning.
Well, it sure has. The shot blocked away, and I think we expected a contest similar and very competitive and evenly matched. I don't think we expected the route to this score for either team.
No, I don't.
What tremendous field goal shooting, though, for Nicholls.
And one of the adjustments is that Coach Simmons put guard in the starting lineup second half because of his court production, and he moved everybody over a spot, including Hardy and Nicholls as a second three.
And then Hardy's pass intended for McFerrin goes sailing out of bounds. One of the few turnovers tonight by the Cowboys.
Luke Doyle returns for the Colonels.
So T.J. Carpenter will take a seat. Luke Doyle will check in.
The Cowboys' turnovers are coming trying to force the ball inside. You can't go strong side to weak side in, back in.
Another foul inside on McNeese.
The foul is charged to Keelan Garrett, his second personal foul.
And that's Keelan Garrett, his second. Cowboys team foul team number two on McNeese here in our second half.
They're back into that zone and they get Thomas right back inside. He sets a pick, then flashes to the ball, and he's open, out of the zone.
Easy basket, 13 points for Dantrell Thomas. He's halfway to what he needs tonight, 26, to get to 1,000 in his career. Guidry with the three-pointer.
Good shot. I didn't know that in his game, but that's a very good shot.
Now, Coach Simmons earlier today called him an Adrian Dantley type, and for those who don't go way back in the NBA machine like you do, what does that mean to you?
That's pretty high praise. That's a Hall of Famer there. But look at Thomas again, and I bet he hadn't shot one jump shot.
Nope.
Everything is still around. A hustle player.
And it's his birthday. I mean, he should get the easy looks, but he's had all kinds of high percentage lay-ins.
You call Thomas a guy, he gets every 50-50 ball, and then he scores on every 50-50 chance.
Guidry the miss, Rillier the rebound. Well, you like those odds in this town, Lake Charles. You're going to go lay down a couple of bucks and see if he can push his luck. Meanwhile, Luke Doyle will do the same. And Hardy the rebound. Oh, the entry pass was right there for McFerrin. He got the fastball and went off his knee out of bounds. So the turnover from McNeese. They've started to pick up, but it's been the Dantrell Thomas Show. Happy birthday, 21 years old, and he's leading the way for Nicholls.
What were you?
Six.
And now six. Four McNeese.
This half?
No.
Total game?
Yeah, game. Because they only had like two in the whole first
three
half.
Three this half.
They had three all last half.
And three, how many possessions had they had? This half. I didn't mean to ask the job.
No?
Couldn't be more than six.
No, probably couldn't.
So it's half of their half
right.
of their possessions.
Right.
My point is half of their possessions are turnovers.
Yeah.
Smith and Thomas both have 15 points.
Yes.
Ledrick is 1 for 5 for three.
We're in Lake Charles, Louisiana tonight at the Civic Center. Beautiful evening here in Louisiana. McNeese trailing by three, and Coach Piper's team has continued to shoot lights out from the field.
And it is a high-scoring game, very entertaining game. And it's a game within the game with the coaches and a game within the game with the players.
You like different styles and matchups? Boy, we've seen that this evening.
Yes, I like this. Both teams have really got a focus of trying to get the ball inside, but they're trying to throw it from the wrong side.
And McNeese has had 7 possessions, John, in the second half, 3 turnovers, and it really has taken them out of whatever rhythm they've tried to create.
Really has. And you know, McNeese is now playing slower, and they're dribbling the ball too much, not enough movement. Now, Gidry's had 2 threes in a row. I would live with him shooting those threes until he can make one more and show me he can do that. So I'm sure that Coach Piper is concerned with him shooting those threes.
He's given them a boost here in the second half after Keelan Garrett provided the points in the first. See if the Colonels can answer. How about the body control from Smith? Could not finish. Kay Towers grabbed the rebound, had the shot swatted away, but a foul is called.
The foul is called. The Cowboys.
That was very good post work on the rebounding, offensive rebound, second opportunity.
And Coach, this is the third foul on Guidry as he picks it up right here.
Look at Guidry. He's boxed out.
Dantrell Thomas will return to the
game. That was really good work for the guy who's the shooter right now, because he didn't look to see if it went in. He went and got position in case it missed the foul shot. Now the foul shooter.
Two more misses. Numbers there. Hardy with flush! Kevin Hardy at 19 ducks the season. He won a game with a slam the other day, and boy, he got a foot and a half above the rim.
Well, that's like the opening tonight of the night's game, just like he ended up. We've been waiting to see him do it. Look at that. Look at that extension. Very good. Maybe that'll get him going. Very nice.
They were playing 5-on-4 because T.J. Carpenter took an elbow on the free throw. He did not come up the court. Hardy, recognizing that, pushed it all the way to the rim, and the Cowboys back up by a point. Boy, what a game tonight here in Lake Charles. Guidry with the knockaway, and it's out of bounds to the Colonels, 20 to shoot.
They are now beginning to get used to what Nicholls is doing. See, they're now in the passing lanes. They're not as easily getting tricked on those weak side cuts to the ball. The guy just stayed it.
Great body control, no finish. And then Guidry, after he got the rebound, walked with it.
That's an awful call. That wasn't a very good call. I don't think they, I think he anticipated him walking with the ball, but he didn't.
See if the Colonels can capitalize. Oh, what a pass was there from McBeath. Keelan Garrett lost it. And the Colonels get it back. Another turnover for the Cowboys here in the second half. The pace is picked up. Doyle for a three ball. McBeath kept it alive with a tap.
See, now Nicholls has got to slow the ball down and get their movement going again and look for cuts. And there it is.
There it is.
If they speed up the play like McNeese, they can run out of it. But if they continue to run and get 15, 20 seconds off the clock, they can keep the game and control. Although it's a very, this game is at a high level of shooting the basketball. Both teams are shooting the ball well.
And Keelan Garrett having a career night, equaling his career high with 14 points.
Good, there it is.
Cowboys with the lead in the ball. Here comes Eccles, the step around, too strong off the window. Eccles has made the hard shots. He's missed the layups and the free throws.
Well, half of his shots tonight have been three-pointers. He's like 1 for 5 from the three-point line. And then the rest of his points come from the payment free throw. He's got to get a better feel. Weak side cut.
I think you might be coaching again. No, the way you're breaking this down.
It's a chess match. Neither team can get in the rhythm they want, and they're both fighting each other. It's like a heavyweight fight right now. And this is going to be.
Just a silly foul there away from the ball.
Well, yes and no. He's hit two threes, so the coach is telling him, let's not give him another one right now. That's a great cut, just like we talked about with side.
Dantrell Thomas, 17 points, and the visitors lead by one.
We giving him too much information.
No. Really watch the runs for me here going down the street.
No, I'm teasing back. We're giving them. I'm talking too much. Oh, yeah. Coming. Yeah, yes.
Say that again, Michael. I missed that.
Off the same play.
And you're going to run play. That coming out of break?
Same play.
Okay.
All right. Oop. How many points does Thomas have?
17.
17 is that right? Points.
Come on, check. Yeah, I got that right. Yeah.
Thomas has 17
right.
Points. And what is he shooting? 7 for 9. And shot one jump shot.
No.
Everything's a layup. That's what I call playing to my strengths.
Well, it's the Colonels by a point. They have scored the same basket in the last two possessions on the same type of play.
It's a fake pick cut off the weak side. Same thing. He just backdoors. He's late. No help. No post. Four guards. No support. Four out.
That's why the Colonels continue to shoot well over 60% for the game. But their lead only a single point. The Cowboys have a chance to regain it here. Back and forth we've gone in the last few minutes. Fields was denied.
That I'm sure Coach Simmons did not want that coming out of the timeout. That was a going sideways, nothing to the rim, attacking it, and then a three-point shot. That could not have been what he wanted.
And they're lucky it didn't lead to a basket on the other end.
Yeah.
One man who's given them a lift, Deshari Guidry on the low blocks here, provided 10 points in the game. A man who last year against Nicholls had 34 against this team. Keelan Garrett, boy, stepping out from long range, follows his miss. And the ball remains in McNeese's favor.
Eccles is out of the game right now.
Returning for the Colonel,
and they don't seem to know where they want to go to get points. McNeese, the last two possessions, they don't seem to. And here comes Eccles
right back
in the game. Can't be off the floor right now. And he took the guy who took the bad shot with that possession out of that time. Unfortunate for him.
Guidry goes to work. Again, a huge career night against Nicholls last year. And he drew the foul on McBeath, who's getting frustrated at some of the contact.
McBeath is a grown man. Because Guidry's a grown man. And those two Toronto Bulls bumping each other. But if McBeath has to go out the game, that takes them away from having a big. So they have to come back small back in the game because the other guys are injured. The other bigs are injured.
He'll have to take a seat. With this four fouls, Jadonte Frye, a freshman, just 6'3", replaces him. Boy, Sean Johnson got drilled on that shot. No foul, no basket. Carpenter on the other end. He looked like he got fouled, nothing called. Cowboys will try and run again. Sean Johnson to the basket, and the Cowboys are back in front by a point. It's 8 points for Johnson off the bench. Nearing the halfway point here in our second half.
They're moving. They have to run their offense, be patient, looking for those slice cuts.
Boy, Smith denied by Eccles, and he gets whistled for the body, the contact.
The foul is called on Kevin Hardy. It's his third personal foul.
This is a really nice up and under move by Johnson. Really good, very clever for a guy. Little guys have got to be able to do that. Be able to score
right.
And flip. You know, right now, we see Smith shooting his free throws. He is really effectively one of their post players because all of the cutting ends up with him coming to his left hand into the post. And he is really effective in the post. But as this game wears on, their Achilles heel will have to save them tonight, that free throw shoot.
Seems like one of two is about what we get from both teams, as you saw that previous graphic and the shooting percentages from the stripe. But we're tied at 56. Keelan Garrett, a new career high. Keelan Garrett has three threes tonight and 17 off the bench.
He has almost all the bench points. He's really been effective. I actually like that he could actually be a starter, but I'm sure Coach Simmons wants his points off the bench because he is really giving them a big lift back inside with the cut. It's nothing different. It's the same play, same movement. Either the cut from the top or the weak side.
So how frustrated are the Cowboys right now that they just can't stop?
Well, Cowboys are okay because they can score. They can't stop the Cowboys either. The Cowboys has found a number of ways to score, but the turnovers, but if they don't guard them and get stopped and score themselves, they can't create the turnovers. Because here we go again. Top cut, now it'll be a weak side cut.
Frye fell down in the lane. Carpenter had the hot hand early. He's cooled off since. Cowboys by a point with the ball. Keelan Garrett comes back 1-on-5. Sean Johnson with the three-point miss. And Frye up high for the rebound. Fouled by Hardy.
The foul is called on Kevin Hardy.
And now foul trouble beginning to creep up for guys like McBeat and now four on Hardy.
Hardy needs to come out. Coach needs to sit and talk to him and get him calmed down. He's a little frustrated because the game isn't going his way tonight. He missed the tips. He hadn't been able to get his foul. And coach is taking him out. Needs to settle him down. There's a lot of time left in this game. 8 minutes. You'll see him come back about the five-minute mark. But he needs to talk to him and calm him down.
And here's a guy that's played 40 minutes in a lot of games this year. Coach Simmons told us he needs to play 40 in a lot of games. Right now, he can't. He'll have to sit.
Well, you don't miss him tonight as much because Guard has really stepped up and provided a lot of scoring.
Well, Carpenter had an easy look and had that ball knocked out of bounds to the Cowboys.
In the game now for the Cowboys, a 6'3 senior from Dallas.
Let's take another look at this one.
Same cut. Here's the two things. The first cut's from the top off of a fake screen. The second one is a slice cut from the weak side. No difference. Same play. Everything. But the problem with guarding it, they run it both sides equally as well. You know, you get used to one side, but they run it both sides. So you use different people in the cut every time. Hard to prepare. When I was in college, there was a team that played like this called Princeton with Pete Carrell. You had to practice a week. If you could only see them limited time, you could not get used to it. But if you had the time to practice and get the discipline, the mindset, you could get to them. And this is how they remind me so much of old Pete Carrell's team. The discipline run the offense. And you just have to stay true to what you do.
Guidry follows his miss on the second try. It looked like he had a block from Thomas, and Thomas can't believe he got called for a foul.
Well, that looks a little bit like Adrian Dantley there, for sure.
This game's getting physical. It has been evenly matched throughout. The Cowboys from Dave Simmons lead the Colonels by a point. Once we get inside one of these, like when they give me a run, I'll have this, like lead change. If it changes two or three times under the media timeout, just track that too. Like I'll get it back if it's 14, if it goes 15, 16, 17 before I get to the next media timeout where I can check that again. We can do one now if you want. That's fine. Okay. Exactly. Just make sure you tell me which one we're going to first. We have had six ties and 14 lead changes tonight, John Lucas, here in Lake Charles.
Very good game. I told you it's a chess match, and this game's going to come down to whether Nicholls can make the free throws and whether McNeese can stay with what they're doing with a nice inside-outside attack and the right people shooting the three-point shot. Right now, as you come down the stretch, they've got to get to the foul line. Guidry's got to get some touches as they play because Nicholls will run what they're doing here. And I like that they're picking up and beginning to put pressure to speed them up a little bit.
Three-point lead for McNeese. Willier couldn't get it to go. How about Thomas going up high for the rebound and then... You see the ball remain in Nicholls' favor. Home fans don't care much for that call.
Thomas is very athletic for his size. Did you see how high he walked? Look at this. Look at that.
Maciel into the game. So it's Thomas again going to work. Feeding Rillier, cutting to the basket. John, will foul problems begin to cause McNeese some issues as they start to pick up a few?
Well, no, not necessarily, because both teams are small, so they have perimeter guys to guard. But the Gidry is the one guy that can't pick up those fouls like that, because he's the one guy that's a mismatch.
And maybe the worst free throw shooter on the team, shooting 39%, makes a free throw. Fun game, isn't it?
And TJ Carpenter.
If you notice, both of these coaches really know their team very well. You never see Thomas and Smith off the court at the same time. One rests, the other's in. Never see both of them off, because they need both of them to play. The one brief possession that McNeese had, Thomas and Gabriel, he got Eccles right back in the game.
This is Eccles here driving against Jeremy Smith.
The foul is called on Jeremy Smith. That's his
second. Both teams have a little bit of trouble guarding dribble drives. Now, they do it different ways. McNeese dribble drives off with the perimeter, no screens. The dribble drive comes from Nicholls, is off the swing of the ball and back cuts. Two different ways to get the same thing accomplished. That's why this game is short. But there's such a high-level game. This is high scoring.
And Eccles, with that hit, gives the Cowboys the largest lead they've enjoyed at any point tonight at 4.
And Thomas comes back. We're in the end of the game. This is a big possession in this game right now.
And a man who steps out hasn't hit a three all day. Luke Doyle knocks one in.
Luke, that was big time for Luke.
Well, how about that? Not bashful at all. Maybe the biggest possession for the Colonels yet tonight. He knocks it in. It's a one-point game again. And another whistle. This one, I believe, going against Carpenter with the knee.
The foul is called on T.J. Carpenter. That is his second personal foul. Seventh team foul. 1-1 now for the Cowboys.
Carpenter has a tough matchup as you watch this. He just physically can't guard Gidry, and that's a big difference for the girth of Gidry. He's doing a good job, but he's got to beat him to the spot.
And there's your free throw updates.
Which team can't make the free throws?
That's pretty evenly matched, too.
Yeah.
And another foul on the other end. You go back to that previous three, though, by Doyle. McNeese had outscored the Colonels 27-0 off the bench until that big three-pointer.
Yeah. And that was a 5- or 6-point game. So they get that rebound and score. Now the game changes. Nicholls would have had to speed their pace up. Now, Gidry misses the free throw. These free throws become big. Smith.
And the lefty drains it. 17 for Jeremy Smith. Good look at Coach Piper. He said, my 37 years, player or coach, I've never gone through anything quite like this. But how about that? Back-to-back makes him Smith. And now McBeath, with his four fouls, checks back in for Coach Piper.
And he will go immediately to Gidry, because he feels, Coach Piper feels they're going to go back inside to Gidry. So this is matchup, and McBeath goes right over there to Gidry to try to offset any double teams on that.
Colonels were down 4 just a moment ago, back up by a single point. Three games with these two teams last year decided by a total of 7 points. One was in double overtime. One was in the conference tournament. Cowboys took 2 out of 3.
They've taken too long to get the ball to Gidry. Now they will have to put up a bad shot.
Gidry will hoist from the baseline right into the hands of Carpenter.
If he had looked up the floor, they had Smith out for a layup. As you shuffle. Had him right there.
Boy, it was open.
Right there. And he's got a smaller guy on him. It's too small. up.
All but down. That shot popped out, but he had the position.
Timeout, Cowboys.
And Coach Simmons wants a timeout. So that's a 30. It should become a full timeout as we're inside 5 minutes to play. Tonight from Lake Charles.
That's a very good timeout.
We'll step aside, come back for the final 5 minutes. What a great bowl game tonight in Lake Charles. Yes, 27. Yeah, that's good. I like it.
What graphic? What we got? Okay.
Right, okay. This game certainly has the makings of one that'll be decided by 5 points or less. And Nicholls has had some success this year, John, in close games.
Well, Nicholls makes you guard them. They expect you to depend on you making a mistake defensively. And with everybody having to guard, that you will lose your discipline. And in the knee state, they're going to spread you out and attack you. They've only been 1-for-2, and Nicholls is 4-1 in that game because of the way they play.
See if the Cowboys have something designed up off the timeout. Guidry leans in, got away with the contact, and gets the basket.
That's a great out-of-bounds play. Comes out of the timeout, scores, and found another way to get Guidry the ball. Similar weak side pick into the strong side.
Also puts McNeese back up by a single point. Sixteen lead changes tonight, and Dantrell Thomas caught that ball in the low blocks again. Thomas, fouled by Keelan Garrett.
Thomas is probably going to end up with about 20 points for the night, and he probably has done it all on back cuts.
Thomas the miss, but the rebound tapped out to him. Thomas goes to work again, and he'll go back to the stripe.
Guidry didn't block out McBeth, and that was a big possession. Gets the ball back, although he missed the first free throw. It gives them one more foul to get before they go to the penalty to shoot two shots. So that was big in that possession. And these are free throws that's got to find a way to get it.
75% free throw shooter on the year, and you hear the net rip. That's 20 for Thomas.
On back cut.
All night long.
I love it.
17 lead changes tonight. See if the Cowboys can flip that odometer and give us another one.
Hardy's back in the game now, under the 5 minute mark to finish up.
Well, the pass was there for Guidry, could not catch. Sean Johnson with the triple.
Johnson.
11 points off the bench for Johnson.
He and Guidry have been most of their production off the bench, if not all of it.
Grillier was stripped.
Had a great defense.
So Johnson had the three on the other end, now gets to steal on the defensive side. inside 3.5 minutes to play.
Now McNeese is playing with four guards. Matchup.
And Hardy down the lane. Could not drop it in. We'll step aside again. Maybe the biggest hit of the night for the McNeese State Cowboys. The longest, Sean Johnson. And it's McNeese by two. Okay, very good. Okay. Well, it's the Cowboys by two. Now, Nicholls has had some tight wins lately. You go back to January 4th versus Southeastern Louisiana. A Jeremy Smith layup on a pass from Thomas was the winner. And then you go to January 16th, HBU, Houston Baptist. Sam McBee had the late winner on a pass from Maciel, and that led to a two-point win for the Colonel.
Well, you know, they're 4-1 in late games, but McNeese is also 2-1 in late games. So this is put out in the end. Hardy's got to get himself going. You know, he is a big key to this team, and they've been able to get him. Hopefully, he can get himself and bring this game on home for McNeese.
Well, just 5 points tonight, a couple of huge misses from the junior guard.
Oh,
and then Sean Johnson earns the turnover, but going back to your point, John, I keep waiting for Kevin Hardy to have it click and begin to fall, and it just hasn't taken place yet tonight.
Well, if they get out with a win, it would be really good for them. If Kirk Simmons would take it because they're looking for a win, but it would have been a tough win. I would be surprised if you had told me Hardy would have had this limited a role tonight. I told you McNeese would have been in trouble.
I told you Nicholls was going to shoot 56% for the game, and Hardy would have the problem. I don't think you would see this type of score with the Cowboys up by two late. Inside 3 minutes to play. Bench contributions have been big. 30 points, 30 of the 68 from McNeese State have come off the bench, including Keelan Garrett with the ball. He scored a career-high 17. Eccles with the unselfish give to Gidry. Boy, he got hit hard. No foul called.
That was a bad possession. It looks like they didn't know where they wanted to go. They really wanted to go into Gidry on this on the strong side. The guard went back away from it too early, and they didn't know how to get back inside. This is another big possession. Now this is late game. We're at four possessions now for both teams in the game. Got a guard without fouling. And what Nicholls runs makes them get to the foul line. Now they can convert their foul shoot because you got picks and things to go just like there. And this is Smith at Thomas at the line again.
Those words were barely out of your mouth.
It's two shots.
Play defense without fouling, and there was another foul against the Cowboys.
I see, after watching Nicholls now for the first time, how they score their points and how they win late games with the graphic we had up there for. Because you move the ball, and there's so many things can happen that takes it out of the decision making and put it in the hands of the officials.
And a couple of makes from Thomas. Dantrell Thomas has 23 points.
is their two game that they're running.
Keelan Garrett got the bump from Jeremy Smith. So now the fouls have started to creep in to the defensive ends for both teams.
Well, the next foul puts both Nicholls into the bonus, too. Nicholls is already in the bonus, but the next foul, Nicholls makes McNeese be in the double bonus, too. So both teams now coming down the stretch in the double bonus. And the team that's supposed to be making the free throws are missing. The team that's not supposed to struggle.
On a career night, the 83% free throw shooter couldn't knock one in. We remain tied inside 2 minutes tonight in the Southland Conference matchup between 4-2 teams in league play. Thomas went to work, lost the basketball, had it taken away. Eccles, he's not going to give it up, but he went flying to the court after T.J. Carpenter bumped him down, and Carpenter comes over to try and help him up.
The foul is called on T.J.
Now, Nicholls dribbled way too much. Normally the ball is moving without a lot of dribble. That's a good move. And Eccles gets to the foul line. Is any, as good as any guard I've seen this year.
Been in double digits and scoring 16 times this year. He had 3 free throw misses earlier. Again, the game a couple of months ago, he went 14-14 from the line.
That is a strange shot. Really shoots it high and away from his body. Very effective. Look at that.
Left it off that front rim. Colonels with the ball down by a point. Thomas again! All night long.
I'm telling you, if he hits another shot in the paint, I'm going to knock you over.
No, please don't. No, he's hit him all night. I don't like my odds. 25 for Thomas. 20 lead changes in the game. Making 21 lead changes in the game. Sean Johnson with 13 points off the bench.
He really played well. He and God have really kept him in
the game. 1 minute remaining of regulation. 1 minute.
Been some different heroes tonight for the Cowboys. It's been a lot of the guys we expected for the Colonel. Rillier with the finger roll, he shanked it. McBeath was fighting for the rebound. It's still loose. Kevin Hardy has it. Kevin Hardy was fouled by T.J. Carpenter. Bodies all over the floor, John. There's 3 men down.
That's really good. This is great Southland Conference basketball. And this is what they always do. They played late in the game. What a tough break that was. Look at McBeth go for that ball. Look at that. Look at now. Watch the bodies go.
Watch the bodies. It's like a hockey game. They're all falling.
Three, four, and then the five. Already missed the last 2 free throws. He was short on both of them.
Coach Simmons now he wanted the intentional foul. There are no more intentional fouls. He wants the flagrant 1 or flagrant 2. He's not going to get it. But believe you me, the Colonels were trying to keep Hardy from another run out and another dunk. Kevin Hardy just came off missing 2, and the junior guard missed another. Only a 1-point lead for the Cowboys, and you see the free throws, the big donuts. We needed all the rim and more to get that one to drop. We've got a timeout for McNeese. 2-point lead, 41 seconds to play.
Well, now begins the chess match. What will Coach Piper do? In the pros, we would probably go for a quick 3 because it's going to be a second possession. You know, we'll get the ball back again. Now in college, he's got to try to get the best shot. He's not going to run anything different than what he's been running. He may have a wrinkle, but it won't be anything different.
Well, McNeese leads by 2, John, this past Saturday. 5 seconds left. Kevin Hardy, here's the slam. Down the lane for the winner over HBU. He took on all comers for the slam. McNeese defeated the Huskies 70-68. Here we are, 2-point lead again after Hardy made 1 of 2 from the line.
What would you do? I just told you what I would do. Now, what would you do? Would you take the first available shot? It's you're 2 points. You don't really need a 3. But if you got a good look at a 3, this possession is critical. I would foul right away if we miss. to lengthen the game. It'll be interesting because if I get under the 35 seconds, they can run the clock out. But if they make one of the two free throws, I've still got a chance to withstand the game.
I just like it that you played 14 years in the NBA and coached for three different teams, and you asked me what I would do. I like it. Everybody up on their feet here at Lake Charles. Let's see what the Colonels can do.
Same offense.
Smith to the rim. We're tied again. A career high 20 points for Jeremy Smith.
He is just exactly what the coach described. You can't run him off. I mean, he got the ball corner, which, look at that. That's just a very good athletic move going to his right and left. Very good.
Boy, the bench has played such a big role for McNeese. The bench for Nicholls reacts 22 lead changes in this game.
Would you want it another way? That's all we talked about, how they go back and forth all night. I mean, would you expect any different?
Eventually, though, you see one team maybe separate, extend some mistakes. It just hasn't occurred, and that's what's made this game thrilling.
Well, now McNeese should have the last shot. Last time they went a little early in the game, they won. This time they got to take all the clock. This is the last shot. Let's see where they go.
No surprise, Kevin Hardy will be the man who controls the basketball. Walks into the front court with 10 to play. A chance for the Cowboys to win. Eccles for the victory. No! Overtime in Lake Charles. Ledrick Eccles couldn't get that one to drop. No friendly roll. Dave Simmons can only smile.
Well, it's tough to go for a home run. You know, it's a good look. He was wide open. And I love the penetration.
Just would not drop. Put five more minutes on the scoreboard clock. We'll come back to the Lake Charles Civic Center, 72 apiece. I'm going to have to take Paulie Hustle to the casino after tonight. Oh, this is fun. Apiece at the end of regulation between Nicholls and McNeese. You probably saw Dave Simmons talking to the official wanting a foul on this last play, maybe on this push-off, but Eccles just could not get it to drop.
Very good. A good look going to his left. Nice step back. And it was the last shot that game was determined.
This is how we got to this point. High-scoring first half. Things have cooled off in the second. Dantrell Thomas, 25 points, just shy of a career high. Meanwhile, Keelan Garrett has long since passed his career high with 17 points off the bench. And quite honestly, John, that's where things have worked out for McNeese, getting that contribution from guys who did not start.
Yeah, 32 points off the bench, and then from McNeese, and only 3 points off the bench. The three-pointer, that was a huge three-pointer that I told you that was going to keep them in the game, but yet kept them in the game. So now, here's the overtime. I think you see the same as what Nicholls has been doing, moving the ball, trying to get inside and get back cuts and pull. What McNeese has got to do is get Geeky back in the game. He's got 13 points, but he should have more if they take the time and get inside. They've got a nice mixture, and I love the way Coach Simmons has spread the scoring out. Sean Johnson's got points off the bench. Garrett's got points off the bench. Eccles has. Now, if they can continue to do that and they get something out of Hart, they'll be in good shape.
And the Colonels will get the basketball first here in OT. Jeremy Smith, triple team. Haven't had many three tries in a while. McBeath, the rebound, powers it up. Competing for that rebound. And Jeremy Smith got it back. That was just effort and grit from the Colonels.
He gets all the 50-50 balls. And Gidry's called watching down there at the end.
We can't call him 50-50 balls anymore if he gets all of them.
He gets them all. And he's such a high-energy guy. This is energy level.
New Orleans, Louisiana native. 21 tonight for Jeremy Smith. He had 17 the other day in the loss to A&M Corpus Christi and only missed two field goals all game. Now in overtime, he's being called upon to do it from the stripe. Perfect. That's 47 points between Thomas and Smith combined.
Over half the points.
Flying in for the rebound with Sean Johnson. Eccles begging for the basketball in the far corner, waving his hands over his head. He had a chance to win it at the end of regulation. Goes for the lead here. And another rebound. Johnson's got a pair of this sequence. Hardy with the step back. And finally Smith up high for the carom.
Three shots. Nothing inside. To Gidry. You got to go inside out. Where did Nicholls start? On the post.
McBeath will step out from a long range. He's hit three of those tonight, but none bigger than this one in overtime.
This is a big possession coming up from McNeese. They lose complete control of this. Coach Piper's even up on this. They've got to get inside.
Huge possession indeed. Sean Johnson's had the hot hand, but another miss, another rebound. Eccles gets it back. Oh, he back ironed it. Gidry couldn't get it to go. Well, McNeese has to get a hit sometime, you would think. You'd be wrong. What a flurry of missed shots and opportunities for the Cowboys. Nicholls run some clock here.
Run some clock, and they're going to run. Nothing changes. And we'll cut to the strong side and the double down. And then it reverses back over.
Jeremy Smith, the left-hander, into the lane. So silky smooth. Timeout.
Nicholls State.
And it's called by Nicholls State. They may talk defense here now at the 7-point lead. Their largest lead was 9, John, but that was early in the first half.
Well, coach is going to talk about getting one more stop. Great shot there. But the coach is going to talk about getting the stop and run what they were doing. I'm sorry, getting you a break.
No.
Yeah.
At times, yeah.
They won't get the ball in the game.
Yeah.
Everything is like, it's almost like playground basketball.
Yes.
I didn't want to say that.
Seven-point lead for Nicholls in overtime. And, John Lucas, the words that keep going through my mind were those that were given to us by Dave Simmons of McNeese State when he told us earlier today, if we ever shoot the ball like we're capable of, we'll be dangerous.
Well, you know, he's right, but the threes that they're taking in the overtime are not the right shots. It's got to go inside out, and I can see where, you know, those are home run shots. They've got to move the ball, and then they've got to find a way to shell the ball and look to the weak side. Because Nicholls is not overplaying. They're just making a shell around that paint, taking away the perimeter here and challenging threes.
And again, a lot of time coming off the clock.
Fouls called on Shane Rillier, his second.
That's
Shane
one Rillier way to score the time.
Yeah. Stop the clock, put him on the line. That'll be Keelan Garrett going to the stripe.
I am sure Coach Piper didn't want to foul the score today because they've been struggling to score. Because now I would imagine that McNeese will press coming out of this if they score. But he missed the free throw. It's a huge free throw now because right now it's a two-possession game. You know, so they need this basket to keep it.
First point in overtime for McNeese.
It's a two-possession game, two threes. And they picked up.
Almost 3 minutes have elapsed here in overtime. Colonels nearly let things slip away at the end of regulation. It has been all theirs here in OT. Rillier pushing it to the basket. He gets the friendly roll. And Rillier in double figures with 10, becoming the fourth different Colonel to reach that number.
And you notice they went smaller.
Open look for Eccles, and he'll bury the triple.
That's a good three. Ball was strong the weak side, and it's wide open. See, it's when they try to get it on their own off the dribble, but when they look at the swing, they sprayed the floor, took the clock down under 10, and went one up. See the ball swing, two passes out of that for the three for me. And that's a good looking three for me. And that's the shortest three on the court.
It's also one of the few open looks Eccles has had in a long time.
Ball movement created that shot. You can't do it off the dribble. You got to get help in moving the ball. See, if you notice they moved the ball twice and made the defense work. That's what Nicholls up. They haven't had. You notice he hadn't run any specific play. He's running the same offense for the whole 40 minutes. The same as Nicholls thing.
You admire the consistency from Nicholls. They've been able to stay in that, but the Cowboys have just had difficulties or lapses stopping it.
Yes, because they have guys who can go off the dribble. And then, you know, they're small, and they got smaller, but everybody's got to match up. So it's a chess match. You know, Geekman has got one of those guards.
Nicholls won here in Lake Charles last year. Then McNeese won the last two games in Thibodaux in the conference tournament. Nicholls trying to win in overtime tonight.
I don't see them starting their offense and looking to score until they get under 10 seconds.
Nearing the 1 minute mark in overtime.
1 minute remaining in the overtime. 1 minute.
Dantrell Thomas. Able to beat Guidry. And the follow by Thomas is good. 27 points.
Take your time.
Really stepping out for the long range bomb was Keelan Garrett. His career high, John, coming into this game was 14 points. He's hit for 21 tonight. He's made four from a long range.
He's been very good tonight. So is Sean Johnson. They really. It's just been the 50-50 balls that has caused McNeese. They get the second shot, the second rebound. They get the. Remember, we had four bodies on the floor. That's the one time McNeese ended up with the ball. But other than that, Nicholls has gotten those 50-50 balls on the glass. But right then, at the end of that, Guidry's there underneath the glass. He's got to be in that fight to get those rebounds. And he's had a very good game.
And yet with that three-point make, I mean, it's only a four-point contest. Still plenty of time left here in overtime.
Well, it is and it isn't. They're going to take the clock down to 10.
Why not foul? Why not put them on the line, see if they can win it from the stripe?
That's their weakness, and that's what you should be looking to do is to foul them because they struggle making shots. You can't let them take all this time. Try to shoot across half court, try to get a steal, then foul.
With a closely guarded Brillier, the worst free throw shooter, and the ball came in instead of Jeremy Smith. So it runs off 6-7 seconds, and they don't get the right guy on the stripe.
Yeah, but they waited to cross half court.
I want to go back and take a look at that inbounds play if we can, because, again, Shane Brillier, 39% free throw shooter, and he was contested and guarded so closely on the inbounds play, so the ball came into Smith instead. And, boy, he has been money tonight with 24 points.
Well, and I'm sure that Coach Simmons told who to foul. That's just the middle lots, because knowing who was what, who's shooting what.
Well, still got a game.
We may not know what we're talking about.
It may not matter. Dantrell Thomas has also reached 1,000 in his career, but it's Jeremy Smith with the hit from the line. Yeah. 5-point game. Cowboys have to hurry. Hardy on the push. They'll wave off the basket. They'll say the foul occurred on the floor.
That's the first definite move Hardy's made tonight to the basket. And he looked good doing it. Good bump, good finish, but no continuation in college.
You say that's the right call in the college game. Hardy's had his issues from that charity stripe. It's not been kind, and there's another miss.
He isn't getting his legs in his shot. All his shots have been short. And they're all short the same way. There's no legs in that shot. You get a little more bend.
Too much bend that time. Colonels another, get the rebound. Cowboys the foul.
Another.
Let's go with the Cowboys, Kevin Hardy. That's his fifth personal foul.
Kevin Hardy's also fouled out, five on him, and Sean Johnson will have to check back in.
Well, I've seen Hardy play. He's a very good player, as we showed in the highlights. Just had a tough night tonight. But I really do like his athleticism and his game.
He's had some big games this year. He will have more. Tonight was not one of those. And he sends T.J. Carpenter to the stripe.
This Southland Conference at the top is going to be a dogfight. There are some very good teams in this conference. Stephen F. Austin and then Willis Wilson, the Texas A&M Corpus Christi, is doing a very good job also.
Guidry. Brillier grabbed the rebound. He was fouled with 17.3 to play. Of course, the Southland Conference tournament is in Katy, and not everybody makes that field, so there's a lot of competition just to get to that postseason tournament.
And then more likely only one team who wins at the tournament will go to the NCAA, and there may be a chance that someone will get into the NIT or something else, but these are tough outs. Very good basketball. I like the way the two teams were very mirror to what we were taught when we talked to the coaches today. It was like almost textbook. But I was really impressed with both teams. More importantly, the toughness of Nicholls tonight won this game. If they turned the ball over, they had chances to go away, and they didn't. It's just a matter of what they did. They defended. Very good game.
That should just about do it. Tied at 72 at the end of regulation, the Nicholls Colonels will finish this one off with a win tonight, 87-79, and John, what a ball game.
What a ball game. Very good game. Love the way both coaches did a great job tonight. And the team, very good. And the more importantly, it was good working with you.
You pointed it out, though, at the very end. It was effort from the Colonels that gave them the intangibles and everything they needed to find a way to win this game.
They scored a lot of points, and I know that Carpenter had all his points in the lane. All his points were layups. Smith's points were layups. They got up, and then the biggest play in the game, was the 3 points off the bench. When I talked, we talked about this was a huge possession. That three kept them in the game.
Well, that will do it tonight from Lake Charles. The final score, Nicholls wins in overtime, 87-79. Join us Thursday for our next Southland telecast as Sam Houston State travels to San Antonio to take on Incarnate Word. Coverage begins at 8 p.m. My pleasure tonight to work with the basketball legend, John Lucas. And for our entire Comcast crew, I'm Brett Dolan. Good night, everyone. Who, John's going to interview?
That's what they told me. Yeah.
What are we doing here, Mike? You?
Double check with them, that's what they told me.
Okay, we're confusion on where we're going. Who's going to know?
Mr. John Lucas, former NBA great.
Who is? I am? Or John is? With,
you are.
We got their coach and their player over here. But are we bringing on Thomas and coach? Okay. Okay, yeah. Ooh.
Didn't he go over 1,000 points tonight?
Yes.
He went over 1,000 points.
I didn't know.
Yeah.
On your birthday.
On his birthday.
He got 27.
I hadn't seen the stat sheet. He got 27 tonight?
27 tonight. One jump shot.
27.
One jump shot.
Now, where are we rolling to the back? Going over here, aren't we?
So that's you doing it?
I think we're both are, but I'm kind of, we're over here?
Yes.
Where's your home?
Manning, Louisiana.
Guys, let me get you wired up.
We're gonna
we'll
get this right yet, I promise. Yeah, we're going to swing us around.
Need anything else from me?
Oh, you're good, man. Great job.
No problem. Nice to meet you. We'll do it again. Hope so. Y'all back in the area.
Yep.
You think y'all need a turnaround monitor?
I'm not sure if we're going.
All right, now what are we doing? Yep.
No, I saw you. I saw you.
I got you.
Player coach, we'll get you right on the line here, the center court line, in the middle, and the two talent. One on
okay,
side.
Okay.
Here you go, coach.
Okay. Yes. Okay.
I'll start with Dantrell, and you can go to coach too.
Where do you guys want us to look at you?
If you look at either, look at him. You know, we'll be filming straight ahead. So.
Okay, hold on 1 second here. Okay. All right, thanks. Back here in Lake Charles, the Nicholls Colonels win in overtime, 87-79. We're joined by Coach Piper, and also Dantrell Thomas had a career-high 27 points. He reached 1,000 in his career. It's his birthday, Congratulations all around.
Thank you, thank you.
What worked well for you tonight? It seemed like you were able to get position, use your speed and quickness to get a lot of easy looks.
I think my teammates gave me the ball in the right position to score under the basket, in the paint, where I do it well. It was just whole team effort right here. It was a big win. I think my teammates just put me in a good position to get the ball.
You know, I called you the 50-50 guy. You got every 50-50 ball tonight out there. And that was really, you got one big rebound out there that you stretched late in the game.
Yes, sir.
But you didn't shoot one jump shot.
Yes, sir. It was all getting into the rim tonight.
Coach Piper, what is it about this matchup with these two teams? Every game seems to come down to the wire.
I think we bring the best out in each other. I really do. There's a lot of respect from one program to the other. Dave does a great job, and we know their kids. They know us. And so, you know, I didn't think they'd shot the ball real well coming into this game. It seemed like everything they put up went in tonight. At least it felt that way.
Well, Coach, you didn't guard them on the perimeter. You made a wall around the rim. But one thing that I loved is you ran the same thing on both sides all night. I kept telling him, if you do it one more time, I'm going to knock him out. He said, you can't do that. Very good job of moving the ball, getting guys in the right position. And I think I talked at the beginning, you scored the first 10 points in the paint. And he had this guy setting picks and diving right to the rim out the press. And then you were posting up. And then the biggest key, and I don't know if you thought this in the game, was you only had no points off the bench. You're down 5. And I was saying this is a great possession. And the young man came in off the bench.
Luke Doyle.
Luke Doyle hit the 3 that brought the game back to 1.
We had a sub at the table for him. And when he made that shot, we switched the sub, got somebody else off the floor. You know, early in the year he couldn't guard, but he made shots. And then he's become a better defender, but it's affected his shooting a little bit. But he hit a big one for us right there. We needed it. That little spark kind of helped us get right. And really proud of Luke. Glad he was able to do that for us.
Coach, overall, your three-point shooting, it provided you with some big hits, too, tonight.
Yeah, and look, we recruit three-point shooters. We like to think we shoot the ball well from behind the arc, but we really believe the game is won in the paint. So that's where we wanted to get the ball. And anytime, in my mind, it's in Dantrell's hands, we got a good chance. And fortunately, it was in his hands a lot tonight.
Yeah, Dantrell with a career-high 27 points. Coach J.P. Piper also joining us as Nicholls comes here to McNeese and wins in overtime. Now back to you.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you. Keep working, young man. All right. Thank you.